Hello. When there is a correct understanding of the words Kam and Khmer, we'll be able to answer all the things that have been lingering in my mind for 100 years. Questions that have been asked, where has Kam gone? The answer is that it hasn't gone anywhere. Still in Siam until the present day. The word Kam is used to refer to people living under Sukhothai. It's a collective call. It is not separated into Kam, Mon, Chinese, Kue, Lao, Thai. When there are Kam letters in the Kam language, how can there not be Kam people? Mon people speak Mon language. Chinese people speak Chinese. Kue people speak Kue language. Lao people speak Lao language. Thai people speak Thai. We have been brainwashed. Kam is a culture. The Kam people don't have any. They have been brainwashed for a long time. Make Kam people understand that they are Khmer people. People from 3 southern northeastern provinces and provinces along the border. Was brainwashed into being a Cambodian. Just ask the Talang Khao villagers, the Prakon Chai people. Birthplace of King Suryavarman II. Whether they immigrated from Cambodia or have been here for a long time. You will get the answer. Locals have been here for a long time. The inscriptions at Sima were written in the Kam language. It shows that the villagers have been speaking this language for a long time. Prakon Chai people, Phi Mai people. Birthplace of King Suryavarman I. Go build a new city at Phranakon. Because it is more fertile until Angkor Wat was built. Angkor Thom was built by bringing Khmer slave labor to build the temple. Until the reign of King Jayavarman IX, slaves of the Cham and Khmer descent rebelled to seize control of the Khams, causing the prince to seek refuge in Lao, which is a city of relatives and built Ayutthaya. Not long after that, at the end of the reign of King Yuthong, must be given to a son who is not yet very young. Travel to conquer Kam Phra Pak, which is not far away. He is the real grandchild of King Yuthong, and can simply be called his younger sister's child. He is the child of King Tengwan. By having the king's son's uncle raise an army to help fight. Until victory, the word Kam defected. So it happened at the end of the reign of King Yuthong. When you know the truth, the origin of the words Kam and Khmer, we'll understand history as it really is. Don't believe the French brainwashing. The Khmer message says Thailand steals Khmer land. Stealing Khmer culture, it will be reversed like the other hand. It was the Khmers who stole the land of Siam. And stole the culture of Siam to this day. I still don't steal and I won't stop. This is because the Khmers do not have any culture to be proud of. It has no culture of its own. So they had to steal the culture of neighboring countries. Stealing a cane from Laos currently, Khmer still do not know how to play cane. Have you ever heard that there are Khmer words in Thai? Became a request in Thai. Khmer is also a nation that stole the Kam language and used it. Today it is understood that the Kam language is its own language. The Funan Kingdom arose around 68 AD, corresponding to 611 AD. At that time the Funan people still don't speak Khmer. Plus, it can be said that it has been said for 650 years. Compared to the Kam language and the Kam community. In Sima City, it is 3,000 years old. The age of the reclining Buddha at Sima City. It predates the Funan Kingdom by 1,000 years. Cities founded since prehistoric times. Muang Sima is a large city, speaking the Kam language. At that time, the Funan Kingdom had not yet been born. Just so you know who was born first. During this time, the Cambodian people must be very shocked. Because the Khmer Empire didn't really exist. The word Sara Khmer in the inscriptions of that period means village only. Today I'm telling you just this. We'll tell a new story. Please listen again next time. For today, goodbye.